Faculty of Science in SRN International School, Jagatpura, Jaipur, and I welcome you all to the official YouTube channel of SRN International School. Today, in this video, we will be looking at acids and bases. This is a very important chapter in class 10 chemistry. Now, when we deal about acids and bases, the question that comes into our mind is, how do the acids look like? What are acids? What is their use? How do the bases look like? And what is the use of the bases? So let us discuss that what can be the basic difference between an acid and a base. Now, there can be various tests to distinguish between an acid and a base. Acids that are usually stored in they have the capacity to give H plus ions. They are very, very sour in taste. For example, lemon, which contains acid. They have also the capacity to turn blue litmus red. It is generally observed, students, that stronger is the acid, stronger is the tendency of this substance to give the H plus ions. So the strong acids are having a very good tendency or capability of giving the H plus ion. For example, hydrochloric acid. This hydrochloric acid is also called as muriatic acid and it can easily give H plus ions. The strong acids, they can completely dissolve in water. So this is one more characteristic of the acids. Now, as we have already discussed that the tendency of a substance to give H plus ions determines its acidity. The acids are very hazardous to our skin. In case accidentally if any of the acid falls on our skin, then they can also cause ulcers or burns on the skin. So we need to be very cautious while dealing with the acids in the laboratory. Let us now discuss that how these acids are different from the bases. So we will be discussing how are the acids quite dissimilar when they are compared with the bases. So let us now see that what are the uses of acid. So when we come to the uses of acid, we have to discuss certain acids such as hydrochloric acid. Now this hydrochloric acid, as we have already discussed, is also one of the most strong acid. It is used to clean the sinks, especially in the kitchen, or it can also be used in the toilet cleaners. It is also used in the sanitary wares. Now let us discuss one very important acid that is also called as the king of acids, and this is none other than the sulfuric acid. The sulfuric acid is used in the carpets and in the manufacturing of paints, rugs, dyes and fertilizers. Now let us discuss the nitric acid. Nitric acid is also used to clean gold and silver ornaments. It is mixed with hydrochloric acid and is called as aqua regia. Let us now discuss that what can be the characteristics of a base. As we have already discussed, the substance which gives OH ions is called as a base. So the tendency of a compound to easily give OH ions determines its basicity. The bases are bitter in taste as compared to the acids, which are sour in taste. The bases, they can convert the red litmus to blue color. And yes, the bases are also very, very hazardous. The bases which are soluble in water are called as alkalis. And at times we dissolve the bases in order to form the alkalis. Now what is the use of a base? When we discuss about the bases such as sodium hydroxide, then we discuss that it is used in cleaning purposes. Now let us come to the topic, that is salts. Now what are salts? The salts are actually the compounds that are formed when the hydrogen of an acid is replaced by a metal. They are made when an acid reacts with a metal, an alkali or a metal carbonate. These salts are of various types. For example, you would have heard of sodium carbonate, sodium chloride, zinc chloride, magnesium chloride. So these are some of the salts. Now let us discuss the use of a very important salt, that is Epsom salt. Epsom salt is also called as magnesium sulfate, and it is used in the bathing salts. Ammonium nitrate, which is NH4NO3, is used in the fertilizers. Baking soda, which is sodium bicarbonate, is used in the cooking purposes. It is also called as Meetha soda, and it is widely used in the household. Now let us discuss the identification of acids and bases on the basis of pH. Now the first question that comes into our mind is, what is pH? pH means the power of hydrogen. Acids have a pH range from 0 to 7, whereas the lower pH value indicates the stronger acid. Now the bases, they are having a pH range of 7 to 14, and any higher value of pH indicates a stronger base. Now let us discuss once again, what are the acids having the pH of 0 to 7? That means an acid having a pH value somewhere around 2 or 3 will be regarded as a stronger acid as compared to a pH value 5 to 6. Now children, let us discuss that who gave this pH scale. This pH scale was given by a scientist named Sorensen. Now what is pH actually? pH is the logarithmic scale, and it values from 0 to 14, where 0 to 7 is acid, 7 to 14 is a base, and any value exactly 7 is neutral. Now let us discuss that what is the pH of a substance if it is exactly 7. Now if a substance has pH value 7, it will be regarded as a neutral substance, for example water. Now what is the range of base? What is another name for a base? Now bases have range of pH from 7 to 14, and they are alkaline. They are also called as alkaline substances. So students, if you are actually facing any kind of problem in acids and bases, I think this slide is the best solution to this, where you will get all your questions, where you will get all your answers. So be at home, be safe, keep shining, and if you really like this video, please share and subscribe our channel. And I'll be coming with more exciting videos later in this unit. Thank you very much. Thanks for watching.